May the 20th, 2010 started out like any other day. Two veterans of our West Memphis, Arkansas Police Department, Bill Evans and Brandon Powdert, were patrolling the interstate as part of the department's drug interdiction team, something they loved to do. They became involved in what seemed to be a routine traffic stop, though I've always warned my officers there is no such thing. But really, how much more routine can you get than pulling over a father and son in what looked like a church bus? My men didn't realize who or what they were dealing with. Neither officer made it home. And one of them was my son.
Exit 275 on 40. These guys just shot a police officer right on the exit.
You said that officer's been shot on the 270 what?
Exit 275 on 40.
275 on 40. Where are you right now?
I'm at the exit just right in front of me, about 100 feet.
Okay, it's a white what?
It's a white caravan, a white guy. Please hurry. He's not. He called the dead. I was in the ditch. They're both dead now. They killed both cops. They shot one. He fell in the ditch. The other one ran behind the car, and they shot him in the head.
All right, where's the suspect now?
They just left in a white caravan. They went right up the exit. That guy had an automatic weapon. They're all with automatic weapons.
So where are you at now?
I'm standing right over the top.
What kind of are you in?
Oh, I'm in a FedEx truck. You can't miss it. It's huge. Tell the cop to come forward. He's coming.
There was a white unmarked fossil incident that had shot fired. Possibly a white van was going to be the suspect. 6 feet if you got more traffic, he's alright with me.
Jerry and Joe Kane were finally stopped for good after they killed my son and his partner that day, but not two other courageous officers were injured. We, as law enforcement professionals, face danger every day. We know that's part of our job.